gentlemen, Spellbound presents Martin St. James.
Thank you, Anthony. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, oh, we're back here and we're back. Look, what's the name of this place?
Renmark.
That would like to come up and experience the wonderful feeling of being suggestionized, mesmerized, paralyzed, pasteurized, sterilized, hypnotized, and circumvented. There's a lot of people up here. Come on, don't be shy. Give me my hands there. Come on. Come on and take a seat up here. That's the way. Look at them from all directions. That's the way. Keep them coming. Right. Oh, look, my glance to the smaller.
Thank you.
every one of you, but when I count to three this time, you'll keep your eyes closed tight, you'll not get out of your seats, but you'll all imagine it's Monday afternoon, and you're all back at your usual jobs, doing whatever you do on a Monday afternoon. Now do not get out of your seats, keep your eyes closed tight, just go through the actions of doing whatever you do on a Monday afternoon. One, two, three, it's Monday afternoon. Get off your work, do whatever you do on a Monday afternoon.
Washing the car.
Oh, well, keep on with it. What are you doing?
business, Max.
I see. Well, look, you're all working too hard. When I count to three, you'll go deep asleep. One, two, three, sleep. Deep asleep. Sit straight back and go deep asleep now, because each and every one of you, you've got a mechanism, and Max, you are a typewriter. You are a working typewriter. Yes, you are a typewriter. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll take note of the demonstration and outline the secret. Usually, the members of two people react the same. Every person's imagination. You can go entirely different from the next. There's a wonderful typewriter up here. Look at the beautiful typewriter over here. Wonderful typewriters, all sorts of typewriters. Look at this one really going to town over here. All sorts of typewriters we've got up here. Great typewriters. This one's a government typewriter, not doing much over here. Yes. When I count to three this time, you're a washing machine. One, two, three, you're a washing machine. And then you're a washing machine. You see the various types of washing machines we have here. All sorts of washing machines. Yes, yes, we've got all types of washing machines we have here. Oh, this is the time to get your clothes in a knot over here. All sorts of washing machines we've got here. This one, of course, is a Westinghouse. Still Westing. When I count to three this time, you're a pneumatic drill. One, two, three, you're a pneumatic drill. We've got all sorts of teapots here. But when I count to three this time, you're a pretty goldfish in a bowl. One, two, three, you're a pretty goldfish. And imagine you're looking at the bowl with all the funny people out there. It's, you're a pretty goldfish. Is this a pretty goldfish or isn't it? Look at this. Is this a pretty goldfish? Face on like the east end of a westbound duck. Pretty goldfish here. Can I get a good look at this from the audience there? Looks like prune juice. Oh, and yes, and look at this pretty goldfish here. Headline like a mackerel. This is a fish that John West rejected. We've got all sorts of goldfish here. Oh, look at this pretty goldfish. A face only a mother could love. But look, they've just thrown a bigger fish in the bowl with you. It's a big fish. It's a huge fish. And you know what big fish do? They eat little fish. Swim like hell. Swim like hell. Yes, it's after you. Swim like hell. It's after you. Yes, swim like hell. Swim like hell. It's after you. Oh, yes. Sit back and relax when I count to three. One, two, three. Deep asleep. Deep asleep. Now, that was a close shave. Just sit back and relax, because when I count to three this time, you'll not get out of your seats, but you'll all imagine on the count of three that you're milking a cow. But you hate milking cows, but you have to milk that cow. One, two, three, you're milking a cow. But you hate milking cows, but you have to milk that cow. You see, different strokes for different folks. It's amazing how you develop a personality of a person by the way they milk a cow. And we've got all sorts of milkers here. Now, look, I don't know what the hell she's trying to get out of this one. Here, look at this one. She's a real puncher. Looks like it's called getting a bit on the side. Look at this one. He's only got one or whatever it is. Oh, we've got all sorts of milkers. This one suffers from imagination and exaggeration. The biggest others I've ever seen. Oh, here we have the Renmark tickler. This one, of course, has got a milking machine. When I count to three, you'll go deep asleep. One, two, three, sleep. Deep asleep, because when I count to three this time, you'll keep your eyes closed tight. I want everyone to sit straight in your chair so I can see your facial expressions, and you'll all imagine you are the cow being milked. One, two, three, you're the cow being milked. I just want to see your facial expressions. You're the cow being milked. Yes. You're the cow being milked. Who's this one over here? Look, cow makes you milk. Now, loving every minute of it. Like, I'm going to tell you, the cowboy has cold hands. time, you'll not get out of your seats, but you'll all imagine you are mad, crazy, genius inventors. Yes, you're quite mad. In fact, you're insane. And you're inventing something ridiculous. 1, 2, 3. Yes, you're all mad, crazy inventors. And you're inventing something absolutely crazy. Now, I'm going to ask you what you're inventing. You're going to tell me what you're inventing. You are inventing something absolutely crazy. Now, I'm going to ask you what you're inventing, and you're going to tell me what you're inventing. Now, I don't want anyone to say they're inventing nothing, because you are all inventing something, yes? And I'm going to ask you what you're inventing, and you're going to tell me what you're inventing. You're inventing something absolutely crazy. And I'm going to ask you what you're inventing. What are you inventing there, sir?
Anti-virgin detector.
Well, keep working. Fantastic. What fantastic uses of words. What are you inventing there, sir?
Cow milker.
Yes, keep working on it.
The condom that'll fit.
Thank you.
real sex look.
Ah, that is absolutely beautiful. That is beautiful. When I count to three, you'll go deep asleep. One, two, three, sleep. Deep asleep. Sit straight back. Show me true love. Real love. Yes. Imagine, girls, that you're looking into the eyes of your favorite movie star. And it's Rob Lowe. Yes, you'll keep your eyes closed tight. And imagine you're showing the look of love.
Just keep your eyes closed tight.
Ah, yes. You're looking in the eyes of your loved one. And, fellas, you're looking in the eyes of the centerfold Playboy bunny of the month. Yes. Oh, yes. Show me true love as you look into the eyes there. Show me true love. Ah, that is absolutely beautiful. That is marvelous. Now, look, what we're going to do now, we're going to do a movie improvisation. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to walk up to you, and I'm going to say the word love. Now, as soon as I say... Just sit back, don't touch her, just sit back and look at her eyes. Yes. Now, listen, we're now going to do a movie improvisation. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to walk up to you and I'm going to say the word love. Now, as soon as I say the word love, you just say the first thing that comes in your mind. You can say, love is never having to say you're sorry, or love is a many splendid thing. Just the first thing that comes in your mind. Now, I'm going to tap you on the shoulder, I'm going to say the word love. And as soon as I say the word love, you just say the first thing that comes in your mind. Love. Sound like a Martian. Love.
Sex.
Yes. Love. Yes. Love.
See, I'm not from it and watch it rise.
Lisa. Love.
Boys.
Boys. Love.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love.
To wine, dine, and 69.
Love.
Gambling.
Love.
My husband.
Yes. Love.
Oh, baby, suck a heart.
Love.
To drive.
Love. Yes. Love.
Pedro from me, wife.
Love.
Food.
Because listen, the producer of this movie thinks you're absolutely fantastic, and he thinks you're all going to be marvelous movie stars. And he, in fact, he's going to pay you just for today's audition. In fact, he's going to pay the award rates, and the award rates is $1,000. Now listen, there it is in front of you. Put your hands up, your money. Here comes the producer with the money. Put your hands up for it now. You've got $1,000 coming to you now. It's in your hand now. Check it. Make sure it's all. all there. Check it, make sure it's all there. Check it, make sure it's all there. It's in your hand now. It's in your hand. Check it and make sure it's all there. There we are. Check it all, making sure it's all there. Now listen, there's an awful lot of pickpockets around here. So you want to hide that money in a good, safe place where nobody will get it. Now hide that money in a good, safe place where nobody will get it. Now, everyone that smokes cigarettes, I want you just to raise your hands high in the air now. You grow them yourself. You don't like them?
Play spit there.
Look, if you don't like, just throw it away and I'll give you another one. Just give it and I'll throw you another one. You've got plenty more. Just throw it away, just throw it away. As I say, a lot of people are stuff, but they don't know how to do it. Just start learning to use your imagination. Once you learn to use your imagination, just throw it away, Bob. Just throw it away.
Thank you.
dancer. Where is she? Where's our snake dancer?
Rhythm in the saddle.
What you gotta see there, big dude? What you gotta see there, big John?
You goddamn son of a bitch.
What you gotta see there, big dude?
He's up in his horse, he's constipated, it stinks!
There, big dude.
Horses, fucking horses.
What you gotta see there, big John?
Evening.
Evening, yeah. What you gotta see there, big dude?
I've been without for one day and one night and I'm hanging.
What you gotta see there, big John?
My ass is in pain.
Yeah. What you gonna see there, big dude?
I got a sore back.
Yeah. What you gonna see there, Big John?
Come on, boy, eat your beans.
Yeah. Give me some wind power. What you gonna see there, Big Dude?
I think somebody swapped my horse for a bloody cow.
Really? What you gonna see there, Big John?
Your eyes for the back seat.
Yeah. What you gonna see, Big Dude?
Put him up.
What you gonna see there, Big John?
There's engines in them there hills.
There sure is. Well, then I promise you this time, you'll not get out of the seat to keep your eyes closed tight, and you'll all imagine you're none other than that famous rock singer from England, Mr. Lubrance himself, Mr. Mick Jagger. A 1, 2, 3 for Mick Jagger. Hey.
Favorite obsession. I've been making amends. with blonde hair and a tan, and he's good for a leading man. Attention, I'm just a sweet transvestite.
Show, but we're going to slow the pace down just a little bit now, because right now we're going to bring a bit of culture here to the people of Renmark. Yes, just for the music lovers, we have that wonderful Australian artist, Chad Moore. Right now we've got a great expense for our next artist. Direct from Nashville, Tennessee, the one and only Miss Dolly Parton. This time you'll all imagine you're a chicken in a farmyard. 1, 2, 3, you're a chicken in a farmyard. And you're laying an egg. But the egg is square and it's stuck. The egg is square and it's stuck. Ooh, and it really hurts. Boy, it really hurts. expressions on my subject's faces up here. Just how much they're enjoying themselves. All feeling wonderful, right? Everything all right, Sophia?
Oh,
it smells. What do you think it is?
Look, one of those girls got fish down their pants.
Someone's mum's gonna have great fun with the dynamos.
What do you think it is?
I've even got to change his nappies.
Oh, really? Is that bad? What do you think it is?
Bastard.
What do you think it is?
Same as she said.
Yeah,
she stinks.
What do you think it is?
She's been taking glue and dog shit.
What do you think it is?
Shit.
Oh, no. I don't think so. What do you think it is, Steve?
I'm not eating it. No way.
It's
no good. Eat it. It stinks. It's him.
You think it's him? What do you think it is?
That thing over there should made of dog shit.
Well, that's not very nice. What do you think it is?
I'm not sure.
Don't smell anything. What do you think it is?
Him.
You think it's him? What do you think it is, Steve?
I reckon it's him.
He's got skid marks.
What do you think it is?
Which one of these guys are an elephant in disguise?
That's not bad, Miss. What do you think it is? Oh. What do you think it is over here?
A cheer I had and changed the niggas for about 3 fucking minutes.
What do you think it is? Oh, no. Come over here, dear. What do you think it was?
That bastard had scrambled eggs for breakfast.
Really? Now look, I'm originally from Australia here, here. A lot of people think I'm English because I've been living in London for quite a few years. But many, many years ago, when the Pope played fullback for Jerusalem, I left this country and I went overseas and I worked in America and Europe and all those countries for many, many years. I now mostly work over in Europe. And in Europe, every Saturday morning on the television, especially for the children, they have these cartoons. Excuse me. I guess you get them over here as well. And you always see this guy swinging through the jungle on a vine. He's got this girl with him called, Jenny. Now, loud and clear, virgins, what's his name? Gracious me. Hey, this gentleman over here, will you come over, the gentleman in the yellow shirt. Wait. Can't sleep over here. Come over here. What is your name?
Gary.
Gary, just before I send you back in the audience, I want to make sure that you are wide awake. You see, a lot of people, after being suggestionized, they get a little colorblind. Nothing to be afraid of, mind. It's just the light shining in your eyes. Now, let's get a lady with a pretty dress on, Gary, because I want you to pick out some colors for me. Now, let's really see. They've all got lovely dresses on, all colors here tonight. Oh, they got all sorts of colours. You've got a lot of colour, this lady here. Would you stand up just for a moment, will you, dear? Just stand up just for a moment. You've got a lot of colour there. Now, Gary, from there, can you tell me what colour she's wearing?
Everything.
Everything. Holy sweetie. Now, tell me what colour she's wearing.
Well, alphabetical order or what?
Oh, however you like.
Black, blue, green, orange, yellow.
You've got to be kidding. It's nothing like that.
Yeah, it is.
Have you had your eyes checked at all, lady?
There's purple there too, purple.
Oh, you're kidding. Something like it is a deer. Nothing like it. Look, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you a loan of my glasses, Gary. And you tell me if she's wearing all those colours. There's something wrong with your eyes, so you tell me if she's wearing all those colours. You like those glasses?
She's got that.
But look, I'll tell you what. See, Caroline over here, my assistant, she sells mine for the show. How much do you charge for them? Do you think they're worth $5?
Oh, $5 million, yeah.
Really? Look, if you're interested, you see Caroline after the show because she is the local pornographic supplier for this area. What's the name of this area? Renmark!
The Russians are coming, the Russians are coming.
Shut up, you fool.
Mommy, I want to wait with it.
She's got a problem with you. Right, look, when you get a charge, Simon, nice to have you all up here. nights that get on the grog too much. Right? And what is your name over here? Bradley, thank you very much, Bradley. You're back, you see. And what was your name, sir? Another Bradley. That's unusual to have two Bradleys together, isn't it? And what is your name over here? Thank you very much. And your name? Thank you very much. Give them a big hand as they go back there. Chair up there. I don't know what they were doing with it. You go and sit down and relax there. And what is your name, dear? Michelle. Thank you very much for coming up here, Michelle. And your name, sir? Thank you very much, David. Good. And your name, dear? You just stay there just for a moment. What is your name? Sean. Thank you very much for coming up here, Sean. Good. And, Michelle, what's the problem? Natalie, was it?
Richard? Sexy bum.
Lovers, say that in the phrase. When they thrill to romance, it means that it's so good. Ah, sexy bum. I like the fringe people do. Such a wonderful audience. Good night.